Hello friends, welcome again at way2testing.com, and today we will discuss about hybrid driven framework. In my previous tutorial I have described how to create the data driven framework and how to create the keyword driven framework. So in this tutorial I will describe you how to create the data driven framework, and finally I will give you a link of this all the code in my video description. So first of all, we must be get clear that data driven framework and keyword driven framework, when they are both combined, then it will become the hybrid driven framework. In the current organizations and the current market, they are using the hybrid driven framework. In very rare cases they are going with the data and keyword driven framework. So in this tutorial I will cover very basic and very easy scenarios for your for learning purpose. If you want to create a complex or rigid hybrid driven framework, you can do by yourself. Also, if this session will go little bit long, then I will create it in two parts, but I will try to cover it most of the aspects in first part. So this is my website way2testing.com. here you will get all the things. So before moving to the hybrid driven framework, I want to tell you the scenario what I'm gonna to cover. Suppose that the scenarios are something like that. We are opening the Firefox browser, then we are moving to the Google and we are entering some word in Google search box, means entering some data which is in our one Excel file, and then I am clicking on the search icon. After that I am clicking on the back button. These all the scenarios or my keywords, and the input data which will be entered in the search box is in another Excel file. So before starting, we have to create two Excel file. First Excel file will be the hybrid one. I have given it name, you can give any name, and suppose that it have the input data something like that. These are my website name, way2testing.com, way2sari.com. after that I will create another Excel file where will be my keywords, means the test cases or the scenario. Based on that action will be performed. So without delay, move on Eclipse and start playing with the Eclipse. Here I have created a class. This is the project hybrid driven framework. Inside that I have imported my all POI file and Selenium files here. Now I have created a class. I have given it name get data from Excel. Now what I will do, I will create all the objects, means I have created the sheet object. As I told you, it is good practice to create all the object at the initial phases. Then I will create the file object. I will give it name source as src. Then I will create the object of the file input stream, because you have to import the file. Java IO, you have to choose the IO file. Now I will create the object file, file input stream, to get the data. You have to write the spell correct, otherwise it will throw you error, you will not be able to import. Okay, after that you have to create a method which will get the data from Excel file. So I will create, first I will create a method which will get the my input data. So I will create a static method. So main advantage is that with the static method I can call it by directly with class name dot method name. So public static string, because it will return me data. So here I will fetching the input data. So I will write it something like that. It is my method name, you can give any name. So first of all I will locate my file, source is equal to new file, and here I will give the location of my file, and which is here. So I will copy this path and I will paste it here. and I will double slash, and then I will copy it and I will write it here dot xlsx. Yeah, it is hanging a little bit. So after that, we know that Java do not accept the single slash, so we have to write the double slash, and again we will move on that and I will make it something like that, and I will cover with the double quote. So I have located my file. Now I will create the file input stream object. So I have defined my object name FIS, so I will create the object of file input stream class, file input stream, and I will pass the reference of my path of xls file, and it will say me to throw the exception, means I will add it with the within the try and catch a block. Now I will create the object of workbook as I defined. WB will be object name, so I will give it name and I will create the object of workbook, and here I will pass the input object reference FIS, and after that I will create the seat object that I given the name new XSF seat, and here it will not something like that. Seat is equal to workbook dot get seat at index, means it is a, you can also get the seat by name or by index, so I am customizing it by giving it a string variable seat num, and I will define it here, means I will say it integer seat num. Also I will define my row and column, so I will say the row num comma int column num, and also I will cover it with the try and catch a block, so I will write it here try, and this, and means if an exception will occur then it will throw it out and I will catch it here. I will catch this exception as exception E, and inside that I will print my exception. Print E means whatever the exception will occur, I will cover it, and here I will add the throw exception. If you have not seen my video tutorial about the exception, please have a look on it. You will get very much familiar with the exception. Exception. Now it's okay. We have to put it here. Now I have located my file. I have created the object of file input stream. Now I have created the workbook. I have get the seat num, means what I have done. I have located this file. I have opened it. And I have get this seat num, means 0, 1, 2, something like that. Now I will fetch the row and column. So if I'll check this out, so it is 0, it is 1, means first row, 0th column. So I will move on my clips. I will get the data from Excel file. So I will write it here, something like string data is equal to, I'm creating a variable string, and then I will seat dot get. First of all, we will get the row, so it is row, and I will get row num as I told you dot get cell, then get get cell num cell num that get string cell value, whatever the value will be there I will get it here. So as we say that it is a string, so we have to return at the return statement. So I will add the return data. Whatever the data you have got, just return it here. Everything okay? Similarly, I will create another method which will get the data from Excel file for my keywords. And if you have not seen my previous tutorial on the data driven and keyword driven, please have a look. Otherwise, this tutorial will be very difficult to understand. So let's say seat num. Let's modify little bit it and give it name as seat number no. Do it. You can give any name. I am just giving it a simple name, cell number. Number. And here I will change the. I am giving the location of my second seat, which is hybrid 2. So it will be something like that. Then again, I am creating, doing the same thing, and I am getting the data for my keyword, cell number, and this will get the data and seat number. So here what I did, I have just opened my seat and get the data from it and change it to some other name, like give it name as keyword. So it will be easy to identify whether we are gonna to access the keyword or gonna to access the input data Excel file. Now I will create another class where I will write the code for each keywords. So I will create another class, right click, new class. I will give it name as keyword, where I will define methods for my keyword. Finish it. It will be something like this. Now first of all, I will define my web driver object as driver. Then I will create a method public void. Oh, you have to import the web driver instance like this. Void. Give the method name very similar that you have in your Excel sheet. Means yes. In my Excel sheet, if you will open, you will get the keyword name something like open browser. So give the name here very same as open browser. So open browser. Then inside that method, what I will do, when this method will be called, what the action it will perform, it will open my Firefox browser. Firefox browser. And I want to put some weight, we have to import it here. So Firefox, some spelling mistake, I think so. Firefox, oh sorry, you have to write it Firefox driver, not the browser. Now you have to import Firefox driver. Then I want to put some weight, also driver, implicit weight, driver dot minus dot windows dot timeout. Sorry, driver minus window dot implicitly weight, windows dot implicitly windows driver dot manage dot. Let me clear it. First of all, I will maximize my window, driver dot manage dot window dot maximize. After that, I will implement sub weight. So driver dot manage dot timeout dot implicitly weight, and I am giving it 3 second weight, and I will write time unit dot seconds. So it will wait for 3 seconds. Now my second keyword was go to link. So I will create another method to go to the link. So I will create public void go to link, and I will create the body of this method, and I will say driver.navigate. Always have a good practice to write navigate instead of get, so that in navigate you will get the and I think that I have the URL of Google, so I will write it here, Google URL, and it will navigate to this URL. Now my third keyword was enter data, so I will write it here, public void enter data, and I will inside the body I will get the first of all web element. I will locate my search box is equal to very similar like driver dot find element by dot xpath. You can also use the CSS or any other as you want, and then I have to import the web element, and I will go to my this and I will create the xpath. No, sorry, it is on CSS path. Change it to the xpath, and again get the xpath. And fill it here. Now this method will get the xpath, and here I want to enter the data. So what I will do, I will say just first we will get the text from our Excel file. So I will call the method, I will call the method this one, input data. Where was it? Keyword data and input data, this one. So to call this method, what I will do, I will simply write my class name get data from Excel, then I will put the dot and I will say input get data from Excel dot input keyword. Input data, and here I have to parameterize it. I will give some value, means 0 seat num first row and 0th column. Here is some error saying that I think that class, oh sorry, here will be data, not now add throw exception. Okay, I have to also throw exception here, otherwise it will keep giving error. Now this whatever the data I have got from the Excel sheet, from my input data sheet, I will fill that data in my search box dot copy this one dot send keys and enter the text. So we have entered the text. Now I want to hit the enter key. So public void as it is hit enter key, public void hit enter. And inside this method body there will be something to hit the enter. There is a lot of the methods, but I am using this one because it is very this method work always. I have to create the object of actions class. Then I have to pass my driver reference, web driver reference, and you have to import it actions as a Selenium like that. Now ACT dot send keys as keys dot enter key dot build dot perform, it will hit the enter. So as we know that in Google, whenever we are entering some text and then if we are enter something, it will show me the result. After that I want to click the back button, so I will create another method where I will save the browser to go back. Public void, go back. Then just say driver dot navigate dot back. So I have created methods for each keyword, each test cases here. And for one method intertest, I have to get the data from the Excel, so I have used this class, means get data from Excel class. Now we have done 70% of the task. We have get the data from the Excel. We have created the method for each keyword. Now I will create my execution engine where I will do the actual execution. So I will create a class, the main class you can also say. So I will create a class and I will give it name as execution engine. Execution engine. And then I hit enter. It will look like something. Now I will create these all things within test ng. So I will write test and I will write a method like public void I, and inside that method I will create, you have to import the test ng notation from here, and inside that you have to create the object of keyword class, because you have not defined your methods with static keyword. So to access the method of keyword class, you have to create the object of your keyword class. So right here the class name, object name, I am giving its very simple name, its object is equal to spelling mistake, it is our childhood habit to do so. So new keyword, now the object has been created, class name, object has been created for class keyword. Now our main action will perform. So here what I will do, I will get the data from the keyword, means our test cases which is here. Now based on that test cases, execution will be performed. Test case 1, test case 2, test case 3, test case 4, test case 5, something like that it will happen. So what I will do, I will get each keyword and I will map with some keyword. Let me write some code. Int I is equal to 0, then I less than 6 because we are having the 5 value, and then I plus plus, and inside that I will get the data from hybrid2 file where my all the keywords are written. Data is equal to get data from Excel, because we have created the static, so we do not need to create the object for get data from Excel file. I will write the seat num and I will give it name as, means seat index will be 0, means this will be 0, and after that row num will be based on based on this is row num, so it will start from 1, not from zero. Then I will start with zero, no matter it will not find. Then I will write it here, zeroth column, and it will say me to throw exception, because in case of file it is saying to throw exception. Now what I will do, if I will simply type my if loop, if inside that I will perform some operation. If data means data what I am getting from my Excel file, which is here, the keyword data is equal to, I will insert some assertions dot equals with open browser. Then if keywords is equal to this, then just call the method open browser. Similar like that I will do for other methods. For other methods, if value is equal to go to link, then it will call the method go to link. It will call the method go to link. Again I will create another enter data. In my second tutorial I will tell you another way to do these all things, because it is very easy if you have some less methods, but for the huge method this method is not good. Enter data, and again copy it and paste it here. Fourth is, I think, hit enter. So you have to hit enter here. Keyword will be hit enter, and method also will be hit enter. Again I want to go back, so I will create a method and I will say if the keyword is equal to go back, then you have to go back. So I'm repeating it again. What I did till now, I have just created a class where I am getting, inside that class I have created two methods. One class to get the data for input data, inside that go to get data from Excel, I have created two methods, one for input data and second for keyword data. And there is a keyword class where I have created the method for each keyword. Then here in execution engine I have matching the keywords, and based on that I am performing that action. So I have done with my coding. In the next tutorial I will tell you and I will show you on Eclipse that how we can avoid this process, for loop process, and I will let you know the another method, because it is easy and for small it is a good, but for long project it is not good. So let's run this code and see whether it is working or not. Run as testng. Yeah, execution engine keyword. Okay, it is running, you can see, and also my system is little bit slow. It will open the Google. Yeah, browser have opened. Now it has maximized the browser, it is hitting the URL. Now it will enter the keyword, enter the data from input data, which is way2testing.com, and it has pressed the back button. So I think my test is passed. You can check this out here. And in this video I will also add the description of my website, where the R code will be present. In my next tutorial, I will tell you one more thing regarding the keyword driven framework. Okay, friends, thanks for watching. Have a good day.